According to many scholars, dolphin, they are symbol of natives. Now, if you remember the colonial background, the colonial master used to come and used to rule over natives. Similarly, in this poem, these business tycoons, they have captivated dolphins and they're ruling on them. So, according to some scholar, dolphins are a symbol of native. They are exploited by the colonial master, in this case, those business, powerful business tycoons. According to some scholar, dolphins are symbol of women. In a patriarchal setup, how women are exploited in the name of safety, security, Mangal Sutra, ghar bar dekhne ke naam pe, and their freedom is curbed most of the time, not all the time. Similarly, dolphins, in the name of safety, security, food, shelter, fun, entertainment, their freedom is curbed. So dolphins represent, according to some scholar, the feminine gender in a patriarchal male-dominating world. According to some, dolphins are symbol of black people. In those days when white used to rule over black, so white people had no power, white people had extreme power. Similarly, black people had no power. In this poem also, dolphins, they are powerless. And this capitalist people, these money-minded people, they're ruling over dolphins. Similarly, black people were ruled by the white people. The white people used to control the rain and they used to curb their movement. They used to put them in a ghetto. They used to stop them from education. Similarly, dolphins are not given their due rights. According to some scholar, dolphins also represent kids. How? Now, dolphins are not given any kind of power. Similarly, kids in most societies are not respected. They might be loved, but they are not respected. I mean, the religion of the father or parents is imposed upon the kids. Those nationalistic ideas are imposed upon them. Those so-called morality of the society is imposed upon them. So these kids, unknowingly, the parents do not know, but they make their kids a slave of their own psychological and philosophical thought processes. Similarly, dolphins have no power, no desire. Similarly, in most countries, kids are not treated with respect. They are treated with love. The intention of the parents are positive, but they still are exploited. Most of the time, if not all the time. So here kids also represent dolphin. Dolphins are exploited. Kids are in some way lovingly, unknowingly are exploited by the parents. Dolphin also represent poor people according to some, because in a society the rich are becoming richer and poor, they are becoming poorer. And all the rules, regulation, tax system, they're all controlled by the powerful people, and these powerless people have no say in the rule makings, in the system. Though it's democracy, but it is controlled by most powerful rich people. So dolphin represent all those poor people who have to receive the rules made by the rich people. They cannot make their own rules. Beggars cannot be choosers. Similarly, dolphins cannot be the chooser. So according to some scholar, dolphins are symbol of poor people. Dolphins are symbol of kids. Dolphins are symbol of feminine gender in a masculine dominating world. Dolphins are symbol of natives dominated by the colonial master. Dolphins are the symbol of black people dominated by the white people.